What can I say? What can a person like myself? Live on stage at the Fillmore West Psychedelic Dungeon. Say to a vegetable. Well, I've considered this problem for at least 45 seconds. I've come to the conclusion that the answer is simple, my friend. All you have to do is call and tell them how you feel, as my assistants are doing right at this very moment. Oh, we have to do Dr. John's back. Just bear in mind some of the important things that you have to discuss with these people. One of them might be muffins. Muffins. Wax paper. Mahoganies and elbows.
Think there's a chance that music, pop music, might change the society here?
It already did. Pop music, and especially for the last, say, 6 years, has had a great deal to do with a lifestyle, encouragement of activities within the sexual revolution, and clothing styles and everything else. It's all been influenced by pop music. It changed the appearance of the American teenage way of life.
What kind of influence did the mothers have, you think?
Well, we had some, but not very much because of the size of our audience was so small.
Yeah, but what kind of influence?
Well, I think we perhaps inspired some of the people who liked what we do to get a little bit looser and a little bit more devious. And as I said before, about progress not being possible without some sort of deviation. Meet a few deviants.
Penis Dimension is one of the songs from our forthcoming United Artists feature-length motion picture that we just got the money for today, called 200 Motel. Doing some sleazy driving about November 1st the next year. Meanwhile, boys and girls, for your edification, this is a song of inspiration.
Steve. Case of many dignified ladies, that the size of the titties themselves might provide elements of subconscious tension. Yes, weird, twisted anxieties that could force a person to have to become a politician. Hurrah! A policeman! Yes! Yes! A Jesuit monk!
Dominus vobiscum et cum
spiritus. A rock and roll guitar player! A wino, a vampire, you name it. Or in the case of the ladies, the ones that can't afford a silicone beef up, they become writers of hot books.
Manuel the gardener placed his burning phallus in her quivering quim.
Or Carmelite nuns.
Gonzo the lead guitar player placed his mutated member in her slithering slit.
Carmelite nuns.
Or racehorse jockeys. There is no reason why the size of your organ should trouble you or your loved ones. There is enough troubles in the world today. Right, brother?
Right on!
Which lovely Carol Merrill is standing in front of right at this very moment.
Take it, Carol. Now, as you see, it's an abandoned goat rider. Grand man,
pan, pan, pan. See, it's a reproduction of Sharon Tate's house.
Ooh.
Ooh.
Oh,
I'm last one.
Oh, hit it. Ready? On cue. Everybody sing.
Now, if you're a lady and you got munchkin tits, you can console yourself with this age-old line from grammar school. Help me out, brother.
Anything over a mouthful is wasted.
Yes, isn't that true? Isn't that true? And if you're a guy, and if you're a guy and you're in this audience tonight and you're ashamed about the size of your dick.
Anything over a mouthful is wasted.
Yes!
Hey, you can be tuned in for a minute.
And you're ashamed of your dick? And one night you're at the Fillmore, you're going back to a bit of your pad, and you got this chick, and this guy hits on you, right? You're sitting there, you're really cool, and the guy hits on you, and he says,
8 inches or less.
Hand, 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 hand.
This is a song about the citizens of San Francisco. They keep you regular, they're real good for you.
Hey!
Call any vegetable, call it by name. Call one today.
Yeah, we'll respond to you.
It's time for a revolution, but probably not in the terms that people imagine it. The word seems to conjure up images of sort of a modern-day version of peasants going into the street with their pitchforks to go after the bad guy who lives in a big house someplace on a hill, and we're going to get that son of a bitch, and we'll take all the stuff away from him, and we'll give it to the workers, you know? And that's not the kind of revolution I had in mind.
Which one had you in mind, then?
Well, I thought that it might be nice if it was handled in a little bit more modern, efficient way, you know, without people getting slaughtered in the street. It's a matter of infiltration.
What kind of infiltration?
Because the thing that's wrong today is that the people who are in control of the media and the government and, you know, things that run the lives of the average person in the street, they aren't doing a good job of it because they don't really care. And so if you just replace them, and I think that's a possibility.
By whom?
By interested people from the younger generation.
You think they are more interested in the older ones? You think it's a matter of age?
I think the potential is there in the younger generation. I don't think that right now they are really interested. Their political involvement is on a very superficial basis, you know. They're still they go out for the social aspects of a march or a rally rather than for the what it could possibly accomplish. And I don't think that demonstrations are the best possible tactic.
What do you think of the present situation here in the States, I mean, politically?
Well, it's a little frightening at times. I'm still optimistic about it. Because America is such a crazy place. I mean, it's when you consider that you can elect a person like Richard Nixon just by running the proper type of television advertising campaign, it's possible that a person with an equal amount of money for the same size campaign, he spent $22 million to convince a bunch of people to vote for him, that he was a good bet for the presidency. Anybody else with $22 million and the right kind of PR firm could do the same thing.
Why don't you run for president?
I'd thought about it a number of times before, and then the thing that always holds me back is that what would it feel like to actually be the president, you know, and have to stay in Washington, D.C. in that house for 4 years? That'd be pretty grim.
I saw already some stickers, Frank Zappa for president.
I haven't seen any stickers. I've seen some little cards that somebody printed up. I didn't have anything to do with them. But it's true, I had thought about it. I've thought about politics a number of times, but you can't do it all just from the presidency. The president doesn't have the absolute control in the United States because you have to. The power is divided up between him and the Senate and the Congress and the rest of that crap. And if you go in there and you can't work in conjunction with the people who are in the Senate and the Congress, you can't get anything done.
Ew. Oh, it feels good. Ew, it's dirty!
Also works good on a pie.
It does.
The Atlas Vacmore, ladies and gentlemen.
This takes place in a car on the way from the psychedelic nightclub to the motel.
Say, Howie, do you like my new car?
No, it's real cool. Do you know how to get to the Holiday Inn?
Which one are you staying at?
Oh, the one by the airport. We've gotta get up early and fly out of this burg in the morning, you know.
Oh, where do you play tomorrow night?
Palestine.
Oh, you're so professional. The way you get to travel to all those exotic places. Do you really have a hit single on the charts with a bullet?
Listen, honey, would I lie to you just to get in your pants?
Don't talk to me that way, Howie. I am not a groupie. And neither is my girlfriend, Jeff.
So
Normally, we only like you musicians for friends.
But I thought you said you got off being juked with a baby octopus and spewed upon with cream corn, and then your hair-lip-dyed girlfriend dug it with a hot 7-Up bottle, or she went bananas. What's the deal?
Oh, Howie, all that's true. And sometimes I dig it with a jack-in-the-box ring job. Oh, but we are not groupies! I told Robert Plant that, I'm trying to be chicken.
But I want some action! I want a steaming, succulent, slimy, ever-widening hole with a teenage girl attached to it! I mean, I thought we were gonna get our rocks off, baby!
Not until you sing me your big hit record. I've been looking for a guy from a group with a dick, which is a monster!
That's me! That's me! Oh, baby! Why didn't you say that before? Take me, I'm yours. Fulfill my wildest dream.
Oh, anything for you, my most succulent pop star of a man. Beef jobs, knotted nylons, bamboo cane, beef jerky, ice cubes, mozzola oil, and or including an electric pony harness, air cooled, all this and more, Holly.
I can't stand it!
Me right here in the car.
Oh, you little hole.
Give me the pony harness! Not until you sing us your big hit record, Howie. And we want to hear the bullet.
What?
I have a problem.
Would you like to talk about it?
I can't come.
Eh?
I can't come unless you sing me your big hit record. And you've got to sing me the bullet. Please, Howie. Sing it. Sing the record, Howie. The one. The one, Howie. I'd do anything. I've ripped out all my pictures of Jim Morrison. I've ripped out all my pictures of Carlos Andrew.
Okay, honey. Bend over and spread them. Here comes my bullet.
See you later.